Hey guys, welcome to FreshersWorld.com YouTube channel on jobs and careers. So we got an overwhelming response for the yesterday's video. That means like we have released a video on fraud alerts and online scams on October 2nd, and we got a very good response from all of you. So in that video, we have received a lot of common comments asking for how can you, like they have all asked for a list of words, or like they are asking our guidance, like how to find it out whether a call letter they have received is a real one or a fake one. So I'll just tell you 10 important points or 10 important words or 10 important situations where you have to figure it out whether you have received a genuine call letter or fake one. So guys, first point is email ID. When you are receiving any call letter, just check the from ID. The from ID should be, for suppose, consider you are getting a call letter from freshersworld.com. Then email ID should be so-and-so person at the rate of freshersworld.com or freshersworld.in. If you are not receiving this kind of email ID, for sure that call letter could be a fake one. So guys, the second point is a call. Consider you have received a call letter. So how to find it out whether you have received a fake one or a real one? First point is, employer saw your resume, or they might have seen your profile in some job agency or from an online portal, and they have called you. So for sure, before they call letter, they'll call you and say, like, see, myself, my name is Chaitanya. They'll just call me and say, like, Chaitanya, we have a job role in so and so company, or like we have a job role in this our company. So are you comfortable in this? So if you're okay, we'll generate a call letter. In general, they'll call and ask. Or second case is, first you have to apply for this job. So when you are applying for a job, just lot of people randomly apply for jobs when they are so much desperate to get a job. But you also have to see whether, what kind of job you are applying for, and you also should be familiar about the company names when you are applying for a job. So guys, the third point is amount. In general, I receive a mail from top MNC saying that you have been shortlisted for so and so role and you have to pay some amount for this. In general, I will not say about that company name, but I keep on getting mails from a top MNC saying that Chaitanya, you have been shortlisted for a software role. Our company is in one specific location. You have everything is done, but in order to generate your call letter, or in order to generate your basic info, if you want to register in that company, first you have to pay us some amount so that we will generate you a flight ticket, so that you can come from your place to our place, and you can get your money refunded. Obviously 110% it's a fake one. So guys, the fourth point is where you have received that mail. Are you thinking like, obviously it's in my Gmail? No, I mean to say, there are a couple of portions in Gmail. Either it could be inbox, promotions, social, or multiple sub tabs. Consider if you have received a mail in spam, that is around 80% chance that it's a spam content, or it could be a fake one. Why I'm just saying this? Because in general, this kind of mails, they'll send for lakhs of people. Before you, a lot of people might have already opened it, and they might have considered already this mail is a fake one or a spammed one. So what they'll do is, they'll make that mail a spammed one. So obviously that mail you will receive in spam. So when you get this kind of mails in spam, for sure it could be a fake one. So guys, the fifth one is OJT or training. Lot of people will just simply say or write in a mail saying that you have been shortlisted for a so and so role and the package is so and so. And in general, they'll write a company details, could be a name of a training institute, and a lot of people will go there. Then they'll come to know that it's a training institute and they're not providing a job. Couple of training institutes are there. What they'll just say is, we have been associated with so and so company, so for sure they'll will offer you a job. There is 60-40%, the 60% could be a fake one. In order to generate some leads, they keep on sending this kind of mails, and 40% could be real. But a lot of job seekers, they keep on complaining us, or they'll complaining in the consumer complaint box. I keep on seeing this, so that's why I'm just saying it out. When you are receiving a mail, like OJT training. OJT means on the job training, or direct training word, and then getting placed. It could be a fake one, but there is also a sub case like some top MNCs now, they are hiring for business development associate roles and all, by training them in top-notch universities. From there again they'll take back to their companies. So even that is happening, but when you are seeing this same thing with a small training institute name, it could be a fake one. So guys, next point is proper location. In general, a lot of people will receive some call letter mails and all. So when you receive a call letter, consider if they are not saying the exact location of their company, it could be a fake one. For example, when you are receiving a mail from Freshers World, it could be a call letter. When you are receiving a call letter, it could be like a walk-in. For sure, they'll mention the walk-in details, or they'll mention the exact location of the company. When you're not seeing the exact location of a company in your call letter, for sure it could be a fake one. Guys, next point is company's check. For example, you have received a call letter or you have received a offer letter from a small company. A lot of people doesn't know, they cannot easily find it out whether the company is a real one or not. So there are a couple of websites where you can check whether the company is a registered one or not. If when a company is not registered one, there is 90 to 95% that it's a fake one. For the same case, you can also just go for the review websites like Glassdoor and or couple of websites where they are keep on reviewing about the companies and organizations, so you can also go for it. So guys, the next point is MNC names. For example, if you have received an email like, hey dear Chaitanya, you have been shortlisted for so and so role, and so and so, I will not just say the company names, but those are the very much familiar company names where you might have heard, or it could be a dream company where you want to work for. They'll just say like, we have openings in blah 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 companies, and they are hiring for top high paid salaries for around some 3 to 15 LPA or 5 to 20 LPA. So this is the biggest trap where a number of people try to call them, because in this kind of mails they'll also keep their phone numbers, or this kind of section also you will find it out in some job portals as well. So don't, when you just see this MNC names and n number of MNC names, for sure don't call them. So guys, next important point is interview. Guys, like, it's a very easy or common point that if you are not going for any interview, consider you haven't attended for the first round, or you haven't attended for the second round, or it could be like you haven't attended even a telephonic round earlier. So for sure, how can you receive an offer letter from any company? So 100% it's a fake one. I keep on getting this kind of mails from different places. So it's a very much trigger point to find it out whether it's a fake one or not. If you haven't attended for any company, and if you're getting an offer letter from that company, offer letter means like tomorrow you join, or like day after tomorrow you join, it could be a fake one. So guys, the last and important point is, and lot of top MNCs or lot of some recent companies, they are asking for a deposit amount. I do agree for some extent, and I do not believe in this kind of policies. But considering this point as their major point, a lot of fraudsters has come in online. They just keep on saying this kind of terminology. They'll use the big MNC words to impress you or in order to trap you. So I clearly suggest you not to go for this kind of deposit kind of scheme. Like, in, for example, they'll just say like, you have shortlisted for software engineer role, but you have to deposit so and so money in order to, if you want to break the bond in between, that money will be taken by the company, or if you work for 1 year or 2 years of span, that amount will return you back when you are leaving that company. These kind of situations are mostly happening in current recruitment industry. So be aware whether this is genuine or fake one. So just ask for one of your friends or for the people who have already went for this kind of job, or else you just go for reviews in Google. So guys, I hope this video is very much interesting, and this video is seriously helpful for all the job seekers who are looking for job actively. So if you have any other points to ask, or if you have some other important points to discuss in, just comment below this video. So guys, like and subscribe to our channel. We are coming up with more interesting videos. Till then, until next time, good luck and goodbye.